have to say, Chanel, I am delighted and shocked that you're letting me keep whatever clothes I want. It's really big of you considering the whole I'm pregnant with your boyfriend's baby thing.
Well, honestly, the more I thought about it, I just realized that I love Chad so much, and part of loving someone is loving every choice they make, regardless of how selfish and destructive it is, you know?
Thank you, Mommy. Oh, and if you want to start calling me Mommy now, being that I'm the one that's going to actually be the Mommy, I'm totally fine with that.
Number six, before you try on that kimono, why haven't you had any of the sushi? I mean, we got it just for you.
Don't mind if I do.
That's so good.
Oh, and do yourself a favor. Have a little slice of that soft, unpasteurized cheese. It makes any sushi that much more delicious.
You're right.
Oh, and Hester, you have got to taste this champagne. It's a special champagne with triple the alcohol and a nicotine-y mouthfeel because it's infused with tobacco. Delish.
What the hell is going on?
You're trapped in a web of lies, whore. You just had sushi, soft cheese, and alcohol, three foods that are damaging to embryos, which means you're not pregnant.
That's not true. I didn't know anything about the whole sushi, cheese, alcohol thing.
Fine, prove it. You're not leaving this room until you've peed on every single one of these pregnancy tests. I had all three of you fooled, didn't I?
Fine, you got me, I'm not pregnant.
But it doesn't matter because Chad still thinks that I am. And being that he already purchased our first class airfare to the Hamptons, that means that I'll be the one attending Thanksgiving where I'll have ample opportunity to get pregnant all weekend long.
Hester, I'm sorry.
What did you say?
Hester, I am so sorry. I'm sorry you've had to go through life feeling like an outcast, and I'm sorry that I got angry that Chad's clearly chosen you over me. It's just that ever since you walked through those doors, I knew you were going to be the one to take it all away from me.
Really?
No.
Might just seem like a bridge too far, but trust me when I say this had to happen. And I'm confident that I'll be able to redeem myself morally in everyone's eyes. And furthermore, what I just did will become a new ghost story. A cautionary tale about what happens to hog-faced bitches who try to steal Hotter Kappa's boyfriends. A story that'll be told around the campfire by Kappa pledges for centuries to come. Okay, let's get her in that meat locker.